It was incredible.
It was fantastic. I was thrilled to pieces to do this.
It's so interesting, you know, because first of all, I was backstage with the guys, the surprise guys.
Yes.
And you should have heard them singing your praises while you were playing, Jason and
BJ.
BJ. BJ. Oh my Novak. God. Because they said you were so generous and so wonderful, and as you have been to me, and as you, it's true, and so for us to be able to share the stage is like. It's like family.
We feel that way. I feel that very, very much so. I was very thrilled when I first became aware of Alan
Howard.
And Howard's talent. They're great talent. When I first heard the music for their first Disney films, which was Little Mermaid and then the Beauty and the Beast, and I was so overblown over with their great gifts, and I said, oh my God, it's coming back, the great Disney music. And that's what I fell in love with long before I knew Alan, and now I'm so happy to call him a friend, a dear friend.
And you know, when I remember when my daughters were first born and I would sit and watch the movies, I remember watching Winnie the Pooh, and the magic of that song, and the magic of sitting with a child and hearing their songs with my children, and then to be sharing the stage with them, it's amazing.
Well, we both have a great special club. It's a mutual admiration society. Only two members. Very, very, very limited membership. But we are very proud of the fact that we are good friends, and it's a very nice feeling that we both have for each other.
The specificity of choices is so characteristic of Disney films. You know,
We have a chance to do positive thinking. We have to do positive thoughts. They're wonderful stories. They're not downbeat stories. They're not depressing stories. I think that's part and parcel of
absolutely.
It.
Absolutely, absolutely. And in the world, you know, each one transports you to a world. So you listen to the songs from Jungle Book, they wouldn't be in Mary Poppins. Mary Poppins, those, you know, the songs really are so specifically tailored to the story and to telling the story. And the stories are chosen to be, you know, really appropriate for the Disney audience.
I think we both feel very fortunate that we work for a company that looks for these kind of great classic stories, these wonderful stories, to come to us and say, hey, now musicalize it. I mean, it's the most wonderful feeling in the world to do that. And we owe a lot to who we're working for, you know.
Yeah.
Well, I can only say this. I always feel like I'm in my living room and they're my friends and I'm just sitting there entertaining them, and I felt very at home with them. I don't feel I'm up on a stage with 4,000 people. I think I'm with a few friends around the house.
Absolutely the same feeling.
Yeah.
There's a sense on a sort of a soul level that we are, you know, inexorably linked to each other, the audience and the creators at Disney.
I didn't interrupt. I was going to say that Disney fans and we share the same thing. It's the love for kind of positivism, for good things, for happy endings, for nice people, and triumph of good over evil. That's the kind of things people like, and that's what Disney fans are, and I think Alan and I both feel that way.